Seahawks wide receiver Josh Gordon has been suspended indefinitely without pay for violating NFL policies on performance-enhancing substances and substances of abuse. The league has just announced this. The Seahawks had claimed Gordon on waivers on the 1st of November after the Patriots had released him. He has been suspended, of course, several times by the NFL for violations of the drug policy since the Cleveland Browns chose him in the 2012 supplemental draft. What's your reaction to this? It's got to be near the end for him, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean, your reaction is how many chances is Josh Gordon going to actually get? And the NFL has been very lenient on letting him back into the league after he's had some of these issues. And so you look at this situation, I think every time it comes to Josh Gordon and some of these issues he's had with addiction, I just actually hope that he does well and he gets himself out of the hole that he has consistently put himself in. And as far as the on-field play, you look at what he was able to add to the Seattle Seahawks from an explosive standpoint. We just kind of started to see some of those things. And so I think they move on easily from him, but it's more about what can Josh Gordon do to get his life on track and give him an opportunity to be a successful human, not just a successful football player.
The other breaking news in this hour, Lewis, the NFL history in the last decade divides evenly into those times when Josh Gordon is suspended and those times that he is about to be suspended. I don't want to make light of it, but it is such an old story. He is, if you're just joining us, suspended again, this time indefinitely, and this time for violating both the drug policy and the performance-enhancing drug policy. This is the fifth suspension, second consecutive December. I don't know what to ask, Lewis, besides what's your reaction to this?
Yeah, my reaction is severe disappointment and sadness for Josh, because he is someone who we all know has dealt with substance abuse issues. He has dealt with mental health issues, and those are two areas in terms of the human spirit that are very near and dear to me, things that I take very seriously. I've seen people who struggle with those. I've had, you know, family members who have struggled in those two areas. And it's just, it transcends football. It goes way beyond the football field. And you start to just worry about the man himself. And this isn't about what this does to the Seattle Seahawks or what it did to the New England Patriots before them or what it did to the Cleveland Browns before them. I don't care about that. What I care about is this is a young man right now who seems to repeatedly continue to find himself in positions where he has now compromised his ability to perform as a professional and take care of his family and take care of himself. And it just keeps happening over and over. So you just start to worry and you just hope that he has enough people around him and has enough support around him that they are able to say, hey, look, whatever we need to do to make sure that we keep you away from temptation and away from people who will maybe affect your decision-making in a negative way, we will do. Because that's what it's about right now for Josh Gordon. It's about preserving his life, not his football career.
Well said, Lewis.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.